It was just another Tuesday night, and some dumpy guy was whining about getting mugged. Yada, yada, yada. Heard it before. I was just about to tell him I would, call him if I got something, and throw his file in the trash. But something grabbed my attention, and wouldn't let go.
What is this? You know, this is America, damn it. You know? This is just ridiculous, you know? I mean, I can't believe it. You know, I had my wallet, I had my cell phone, but no, he'd steal my big, juicy burrito that I had in my hands. I mean, what is this? You know, I was starving. I'm still starving. Damn it.
Who the hell just takes a man's food and runs? What is this? The burrito bandit? The great Chipotle caper? Are we in the middle of a great Mexican burrito famine? This is ridiculous. No, I was wrong about you, kid. Together, you and I, we're gonna catch this punk. And we're gonna make him pay more than the IRS. My name was Marlowe, by the way. Philip Marlowe. A private eye with a secret passion for those beautiful burritos. I meant what I said. When I realized I was looking for a guy crazy enough to commit a crime for the sake of some Mexican food, I immediately knew where to look. That private school up the road where the dumpy guy went. Heh. Ah, high school. Good memories. I headed to the library to catch my thoughts and read up on the omelet of the day. But wait. Hold on just a second here. Go.
hand over the burrito, kid. When a man gets his burrito stolen, he doesn't get mad. He gets even.
And so I thought the case was closed. So much happiness coming from such a small gift. The ending almost felt too happy.